Hello viewers, and welcome to Command Modern Air and Naval Operations. I'm your host, PewPewChu, and well, today we're taking a look at another war game. This time we're taking a look at quite the complex and in-depth one. This one would be something that I'd put at the top at that expert type of level, and typically this truly plays out like some sort of actual, you know, use software, if you will. So, Command Modern Air or Modern Air Naval Operations here is available on Steam, and it has been since I believe the beginning of October here. It's published by Matrix Games / Slytherin, and it is, I've got to say, quite an all-encompassing title. Now, personally, I find this just a very fascinating sim, if you will, to play around with, and for the dedicated community, I guess this is something that's fairly comparable with the Harpoon series of game, at the very least. So, with that said, I mean, today I figured we'd take a look at one of the very basic scenarios, just to play around with it, just to see what you can really do with the game. And with that said, we'll hit start a new game here, and we'll take a look at the air scenario, or the basic air operations scenario. And this is more so, yeah, it's a hybrid between a tutorial setting and some sort of a practice range, if you will, where you can just test out running different strike missions and things like that. So the objective here is to pretty much destroy a bombing range, as in, you know, blow up all the targets inside there. Hypothetically, here we're going up against a few red forces, just simply because, you know, just so that we can test out everything. Going up against that, yeah, some MiGs, some surface air missiles, and I think we're ultimately supposed to blow up an airfield. And you can read all the briefing here if you would like to. It's definitely a very say in-depth game, to say the least. So we'll start this scenario off just like that. We'll unpause the game because it runs in real time, and pausable real time. We'll just get it to generate the first batch of targets and get the game going just like that. So once again, I mean, there's a lot of different things inside this game that that make up its entirety, and with that said, we'll go fairly slowly here to check out some of the content. Now, there's quite a few different, there's a fair community of people who play this game, and also there's also a few people who make very in-depth videos on it. I'll link their channels, or, you know, their videos, because I believe they also do a bit of an air tutorial more detailed than I will probably do here, though much longer in span, for those who'd like to check it out. But, well, just giving you guys a summary of our mission today. We are to destroy, we hope to destroy all of the targets here inside the B-17 bombing range, which is effectively everything that comprises Red Air Base over here. And to do that, we launch off of our airbase station over here at NAS Falun. It's an actual airbase in real life, but in real life it's over here, as opposed to the training location where it's here, and they've just included this one, just so that, just for the flavor there, if you will. So, how do we conduct air operations inside this game? Well, we have quite a few different ways to do that. We have, first and foremost, a nice selection of aircraft over here, and the beauty behind this game is just the sheer amount of aircraft, ships, and submarines, and different payloads, and things that they have, and it's all very, very in-depth, rather simulated in-depth, more so just because of just the sheer amount of stuff here. So, for example, each and every single one of the different things you have here, you can pull up as a database entry. It'll tell you all about the plane, the sensors that it has, the weapon mounts that it has, and in general, just a huge amount of stuff for each and every single one of these detailed descriptions. And I believe for this game, it quite literally includes most, if not, you know, everything starting or stemming from, I think, the 1950s up until, I want to say 2010, but that might not be correct, as you can see here. I mean, we have 2007 gear. That might honestly be the end of it, but yeah, it's definitely just a ton of stuff there, and it's all, I don't know, actually it goes past 2010. Judging by the Super Cobra entry here. So, but anyways, yeah, it's a very in-depth game. With that said, it is just a ton of fun to learn and see in action, really. So, how are we going to accomplish our mission? Well, we have our aircraft here. We have a nice flight of, rather, we have, it says 24, but in reality, some of these are in maintenance, so we can't use these. We have a nice set of, Tomcats, some Corsairs, some Intruders, and some other planes here for us to use. And what I think I'll do here is that I'll do this mission in parts. So, first and foremost, we want to take out those MiGs that the mission briefing was talking about that were buzzing around Red Airbase here. So I think we'll launch a few Tomcats just to clear the air, if you will. So we'll launch a few F-14s. And how this works is that we can control these planes manually, where we can assign them missions for them to just kind of do by themselves. And with that said, I'm going to do the first leg of this by myself. So what we can do here is that we can launch some of these planes as groups or as individuals, and we'll get them taxiing to take off and hopefully in the air soon enough, and we'll just let the time run till then. And the idea is that you have a mission editor here where you can set up your missions and all. Set up so yeah, missions using reference points and no navigation zones and exclusion zones and stuff like that. And the AI should take care of all those things by itself. And I'm just going to speed the time to ready up here. So we'll do that. And the other idea is that you can use the unit orders tab here, and you can get your you can, if you will, super micromanage your planes by getting them to attack very specific targets using very specific weapons, change their altitude and depth. If it was a submarine or something like that, you can also change those for those, plot them a course, check their magazines, and just a whole bunch of different things really in the game. There's a lovely simulation of all of these, which is just absolutely phenomenal. So what just happened right here is we managed to get the first flight of Tomcats out of the air. So we have three of them just hovering around the base because we haven't issued it any orders just yet. I'm gonna wait until the second of those flights pop out if it hasn't already, and it looks like we have both of these, so that's good. Right. Yeah, one of the problems with the game is that sometimes your icons over here, they overlap with each other, and it's kind of difficult to split them up once again. But either way, we should have two different groups. Yeah, so we have 174 and 175, or 275 and 274. Two groups of these. Two groups of these planes now up in the air, and because we haven't issued them any orders, they're just cycling around the base. So with respect to that, let's give them a few waypoints and let's give them some things to do. So I'm gonna go plot a course with group 275, and I want them to go around this lake, and I just want them to start heading into the general direction of that airfield. And likewise with 274. Let me pull that up. There we go. We're gonna get it to do exactly the same thing, but come from the other side. The reason being is that we have a few radar detect or a few radar contacts right now, and it looks like these bogies seem to be, or I would imagine them to be, the MiGs that we had read about inside that contact or inside that briefing. So we'll try to go after them. And currently, typically with, or rather inside some of the full scenarios, what you'll see is that you get you get a list of things that match this detection signature, but inside this, for whatever reason, we don't. So all we know is that they're there and they are coming for us like that. And I think this yellow box zone is saying where they are likely to, where we expect them to be. So it's quite a large range. So we'll get our guys to go over there, and we'll see what we can do about taking them out. So there's a safe way to do this, and there's also a bit of a risky way to do this, because, I mean, warfare doesn't necessarily happen in a plane where it's only just friendly units and enemy units. There can be neutral ones too. So it might be a good idea to actually come close to those guys and scan them with the pilots themselves. So we might want to get confirmation with that they are indeed enemy MiGs. And how we do that is we use our eyes over here, conspicuously titled the Mark One Eyeball, but we're not going to do that. How we're going to do this is we see this big blob of ships, and they jitter about the map here because we don't have a very clear contact with them just yet. And what we're going to do here shortly is that as soon as our group makes these turns and all, we are going to get them to activate their radar and to start detecting whatever those MIGs were, whatever those signatures are shortly with their onboard radar and equipment suites. So I'm just going to move some of these movement points. So there we go. They should be heading, at each other now. And what we can do here is we can go to group 1274, we can go to sensors, and we can turn on their radars. And what this will do is, oh, that is not what I had wanted to do. Yeah, sometimes the game does that on my PC. But what we can do now is that we can turn on these guys' onboard radars, and for whatever reason, they are. Oh, yeah, it seems as though whenever I close some of those mini pop-ups, closes the game window. But there, now it's fine. So now that we've opened up their radars, we have slightly, or rather, much more accurate information about these targets. Looks like there's one where there's still something unidentified here, but we can see these contacts much clearer, and it looks like there's a formation of six planes here and two over here. And what I can do now is, well, we'd have to make a call. Are these really hostiles? Well, I would say so, because I've already played the scenario once, and what I can do here is that I can mark these guys as hostile, and well, we can then start to engage them. So, we'll let them get slightly closer here. Our guys already know that those things are hostile, so if they do get adequately close, they will defend themselves. But for now, we'll let them bounce closer here. And we can speed this game up by 1 second, 5 second, and 30 second and above intervals. So there, now that they're close enough, let's get our guys to start to lay off some projectiles at them. Checking out our group weapons here. We have a wide variety of different missiles and different weapons here just for us to use. And starting off, I'm thinking of firing off a few of these things, the AIM 54A Phoenix. These are, yeah, they're guided weapons. They're air to air, and I believe inside the current group of weapons here, they have the highest range. So actually, these ones, they have a range of 100 nautical miles, which is quite long compared to the Sparrow over here and the Sidewinder. Sparrow actually has less range and less probability to hit, oddly enough. So yeah, that's just something that's just kind of out there. So what we can do now is we can go over here, we can do engage targets, and we can do this manually or automatically. And what I'm going to do is that I'm going to select bogey number, 59 and 60 over here. And what we can do is utilizing some of these AIM Phoenixes. We're actually, no, I think I'll get them to fire the Sparrows. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the first one to fire off two of those, and the second one to fire off two of those, and hopefully those will blow these guys out of there. And I would imagine that that takes care of all of the things over here. And now over here, because I don't necessarily want to always manually control our weapons, I'm gonna let the AI decide what's best with group 175 or 275. Don't know why I keep on saying 175, but either way, we'll get them to automatically adjust their weapons and blow up whatever is there. So, what happens at this point? Well, our Tomcats will fire off their missiles, and these I think these Sparrow missiles in real life, they were semi-guided weapons where they would lock onto your targets, but the actual the launcher, if you will, had to be facing the rather keep or the launcher had to keep the enemy faced towards them at all times. So with that said, yeah, the game actually will account for that. Personally, I'm not too big on the individual facts on the how these missiles work and all, but that's roughly what happens. Either way, they'll home in here using whatever system that they do, and missiles go in. Some of them hit, some of them miss, and it looks like the enemies have fired a few of their own as well. So, what we'll do now at this point is we'll get our second group over here to hit this target, and we'll see how the brawl happens. So there we go. Got a few nice hits over here. And lastly, they're still daunting a few of their missiles and all. And mind you, your fighters will actually get into dogfights and stuff like that. It's not necessarily just based upon missiles and all, but it being the tutorial mission and all, we definitely have the advantage with our highly reliable missiles compared to what the MiGs over here have. And with that said, and since we have them in great numbers, we hopefully are able to sweep these guys solely using those. But doesn't look like that worked in that case. These missiles coming in from coming perpendicular into this aircraft they don't really have too much of a chance to hit, but there we go. So all of those things are dead. We can get our group to go back, and the game prompts us for info about the ground strike, because that is the next session of section of the mission. Right, so in the meantime, I'm going to give our F-14s the order to return to base, because they are no longer needed. And well, now that that battle has ended, what I can do here, I use a dual monitor display, so hopefully you guys are able to see my second monitor right now. This is the equivalent of the fight in the calculations that the game shows us. So I'm gonna get our airplane back to base in the meantime, and what we can do is that we can check out some of the stuff on this screen. So over here at the very bottom, I don't know if you can still see my mouse, but at this point we mark the enemy's hostile. Afterwards, we got some basic information about what these bogeys actually are. So our pilots were able to see them. They weren't able to identify them, but they knew that they were fighters. Although it looks like, and they also identified the fact that they were also firing a few of their vampire missiles. So we were able to see that. Afterwards, we had fired a few of our weapons. So that's what happened here, and yeah. Has a whole bunch of stats regarding, you know, what weapons we had fired, base accuracy, range, proficiency, and just a whole bunch of things displayed for us. Mind you, the actual calculations underneath, I believe, are actually more complex than that. And overall, yeah, things happened, all of their aircraft were lost, and all of ours went back to base. So that is pretty much that. And as you can see, it is a very in-depth game, to say the least. So, moving this back to my main screen, there we go. We managed to take out all of their air forces. So, let's set up for the main attack, and we're going to do the main attack here in a slightly different fashion. We're going to do this as a we're going to do this as a formal mission, as opposed to a kind of a solely micromanaged RTS type of thing. So first and foremost, how a lot of people recommend doing these missions is that we're going to make a form up point, and what we're going to do is that we're going to go into the mission editor, we're going to add a mission, and we're going to add a support mission for now, and we'll just call this form up. The reason being is that we want to get all of our intruders, we want to get all of the intruders out in the air, and in general, we just want to get all of our planes that we need for this strike out there and buzzing about at the moment, so we will do that. And again, all of these different planes have their own fully realized info pages and stats about them, which is quite nice. And the other thing is that they also carry a wide variety of different payloads, and we'll see that shortly. But for now, we'll get them out there and buzzing to that form up point. In addition to that, we also have a few tankers, and we also have a few ECM planes, so you can actually jam radar installations and all, but I've never got them to work inside this scenario. But I guess we could try nevertheless. So we'll get these we'll get them out shortly. And go back to that mission. I forgot to disable something, so we'll do that. And I'll just cycle these back. Yeah, there's a lot of these missions set up, or rather, there's a lot of these mission parameters that you can set up inside the bottom panel there. And I forgot to adjust a few, which so happened to make it so that some of these aircraft didn't leave their base, but now that's fixed. Right, so that'll give us everything that we need to make this run. And what I think I'll do is that, yeah, I will launch the ECM craft as well. And once those get out, oh, we will start the, well, rather, we'll start the mission planning phase here. Right, so there we go. As you can see, all of our aircraft have, yeah, they're more so just buzzing around that form-up point now. And they are just doing their thing. I'm going to schedule another course for the ECM craft just to go around the edge of that area, and I'm just going to get them to keep on the offensive ECM, and that is pretty much just that. So, what do we do from this point on? Well, what we can do with these mission parameters is that we can set up a whole bunch of different missions that ultimately comes down to taking out this airfield. Taking a look at the airfield nice and properly, what we'll find is that inside the airfield, you see that there's this red air base and stuff like that. Well, we don't necessarily have to kill everything inside here. It would be best to, but in reality, we can choose to only eliminate specific portions of it. And what I can do here is that we can switch back to group view, where we only see the airfield, or unit view, where we can see the individual portions of that airfield. And well, one of the things about this airfield is that if we zoom in here, what you'll notice is that the airfield is made up of quite a few different structures, and all these ones are individual targets. They also are, kind of fully realized abstract objects, if you will. And what we have down here is a nice mixture of just various different stuff. So we have a runway, of course. We have a few runway access points. So the runway isn't very much use if you can't get planes on it, of course. We have a few tarmac areas, presumably storing a few large aircraft. We also have a few gas bunkers over here, and a few, or rather, a lot of these aircraft shelters, mind you, as well. And in general, everything down here is, pretty much a targetable target, and or a targetable unit, and we can pretty much just try our best to take these things out. But they are guided, but they are guarded by these SAM sites as well, so we'll have to deal with them. So how are we going to deal with these guys? Well, we're going to make a few coinciding missions that'll just pretty much support, or rather, that'll compose, or that'll be, that'll constitute as one big attack. So starting off, one of the things that we want to do is we want to suppress enemy air defenses. So seed suppression of enemy air defenses right there, and I'm gonna make that a patrol. So this is gonna make a second mission. That's gonna select this B-17 area as designated by that lovely red triangle. And what we're going to do now is that we're going to get some of the planes from form up over here. I'm gonna put them back into that pool of unassigned units, and I'm going to move over here the Corsairs with the AGM Shrikes over here into this seed mission, because these Shrike armed planes are exactly for this mission. They'll try to seek out enemy air defenses, especially things that emit radar emissions, and they'll try to take them out just like that. So that'll make seed, and that'll try to take them out just like that. Afterwards, I'm going to create another mission, and I'm going to make a strike this time, and it'll be a land strike, and we'll name it airfield. And we're going to make it runway access. And for this strike mission, what I want to do is I want to have a few planes come over here, and I want them to take out these runway access points, and solely those. So I'll get these ones, the A6E intruders armed with the guided bombs, to do exactly that. So these guided bombs should be fairly accurate, so I believe that will be just like that. And what we can do at that point is that I'm going to select all the targets. I'm going to add all of them to this target list. But instead of taking or destroying all of those, I'm going to get rid of practically everything except for those target or those runway points. So there we go, we'll get them to target that runway access points, nothing else, and they will try to take that out. And we're going to make another strike, and we're going to call this one, let's call this one tarmac. And what I'll do here is that I'll assign a few of these walleye bombers to do that. And again, all I'm going to do is that I'm just going to clear everything here, except for those targets. And we'll get them to... Actually, I'm going to make this a dual mission. I'm going to get it to target the tarmac space and and those missile assembly sites, just because. So we'll get them to do that, and we'll send in all of the walleye ones just like that. The reason being is that the AI will actually... adjust for these missions. So if we have four planes, it'll try to send one individually to each target, or assuming that, you know, one plane can handle each target, and it'll just try to plot very very nice missions like that. And I'm gonna name another one industrial area, and for this land strike we're gonna clear out all of these targets except for the ones that we want once again, and I'm going to hit that industrial area with a lot of these bombs, more so because it with these corsairs and their payloads and all, they're not particularly accurate, and I have a feeling that everything else should be dead by the point that they sweep through. So that gets all those missions set up and all, and as soon as we hit play, that should send in this blurb of planes to do exactly just that. So there. Now, now that I've unpaused it, all these guys are going to head through. I'm going to disable those little blurbs like that. That'll clear the map, and these guys are going to go through and they'll do whatever damage that they can do. So yeah, it's quite nice checking out the mission. So these guys are some of those GBU armed people heading to those runway access points, and it looks like each plane carries four of them, which is quite nice. And yeah, once again, very detailed information on the weapons and all. So I've chosen these ones because they are guided weapons, so we have a smaller chance of missing those runway points. These things are actually 200 pound, or you know, almost 500 kilogram bombs, so I would imagine that one of them is enough, or if not two of them. So hopefully we'll be able to get a few nice hits just like that on these planes over here with the walleye armed things right here. These walleye weapons are also guided weapons, but I believe these ones are actual missiles as opposed to guided bombs. They have a 900 kilogram / 200 pound linear shaped charge type of thing, so I would imagine that these are slightly better at taking out, say, actual structures, hopefully armored, heavily armored things as well. So I sent them against the buildings instead of just, you know, pavement, really, for runway access points. I've already seen those, and checking out some of the more generic bombers inside here, or actually checking out the seed patrol over here with these shrikes. They are once again guided weapons, although their guidance type is that they home onto passive radar signatures, and I believe some other things as well. So they are, for intents and purposes, are seed things for now. And where can I find an actual bomber? Don't seem to be able to find one of the regular, just plain old, you know, drop bomb bombers. But anyhow, we do have a few of those in here. And yeah, like this one. They pretty much just carry 22 dumb bombs, and these will just get scattered amongst a large area. And, well, hopefully some of them hit in that pile. And we also have a few cluster munitions here on the seed planes, which will be quite useful. Because if we zoom back into the airfield here, we have a few of these SAM battalions. That 9 and 11 located above these icons actually say how many different vehicles are present inside these battalions. So hopefully they'll be able to get a nice drop off there and do some damage to those vehicles. Oh, so what's happened here? Well, first and foremost, if I don't really know if you can see like this, where if I have my troops on the map as well as the info panel here, but our guys have just flown across this mountain ridge, and they now have access, or they now have a view of the target site. And what is happening right here is that the red forces are shooting back. Our guys are dodging their pretty crappy, vampire missiles. So that is those two logs. But yeah, that's that. Now I've switched the map onto the elevation view, and as you may have noticed, if I move my mouse around the map, it actually does indeed tell us the elevation, the slope, and a whole bunch of different things here. And yeah, that's really just the beauty of the game. It's just there's just so many details there, but you don't necessarily have to consider these if you don't want to. So for example, our guys have just crossed, or crossed the boundary in which they can see these installations, behind the mountain pass. They're still launching a few missiles at us. I guess our seed planes can't fire just yet, but soon enough, those SAM battalions will be shut down. But one way that you could do this mission possibly is that instead of just launching, say, a mass attack, using the most direct route, you could actually individually get your planes to come in here, use some of these elevation things here to your advantage, and maybe keep your planes low so that they just cross this mountain pass, then they become truly active, and then they they pretty much covered throughout the entirety of the route here. So for example, maybe get your planes to fly into this area where the elevation is really low, get them to cross the mountains here at the bare minimum thing that you need, and then get them to pop out, activate their weapons, and hopefully destroy the area just like that. But anyhow, looks like the strikes are out, so that has probably shut down the enemy SAMs for now, and our guys are just launching their payloads right now. So the mission is doing exactly just that. Things are starting to get fired off. What I think I'll do is that I'll get the message log to pop up right here, so you can see that as a separate, we're in the same window just like that. And currently, it's just a lot of contacts being found. They're firing. Yeah, they're still firing a few vampires at us. Not too much. Or that's not too bad though. And our projectiles are coming in now. And let's see what happens here. So first two strikes, impacts. It looks like, oh, that's actually three of them. We hit three of their SAMs just like that. Took out their radar tower as well. And a few other strikes managed to land on target onto these two SAMs. Nevertheless, that has done quite some damage, especially onto the first one. So that is quite nice. And some of the strikes, unfortunately, just phased away because I think they sent, a whole bunch to that radar tower. One hit, and the other one just, disappeared. These ones, I'm not really sure what had happened to them. But mind you, the enemy is also reacting right here, so they may have shut off their radars. Disabling those weapons in the meantime. And then the second one comes in. Those SAM sites are, for intents and purposes, kind of useful or useless now. The walleyes are coming in, and these ones, I believe, are targeted towards the missile assembly site. Something of the such like that. Either way, they're coming through, and they'll also do some damage. And now what should happen is that the rest of the planes are sweeping through as well, because the strike armed planes have noticed that there are or do notice some SAM battalions inside the area. I believe instead of patrolling the area, they made the active decision of going towards this area and hopefully taking out those SAM sites or SAM battalions remaining with those cluster munitions. So they're flying in here. GBUs are launched. It looks like targets over here, the tarmac spaces. Well, we didn't destroy them fully. They are heavily inflamed now, which is quite nice. GBUs come in, hits the area, takes out the large tarmac area, sets one runway on fire, which is quite nice. The little red blips here are just individual bombs. Those get scattered. Or actually, no, it looks like those are strafing rounds. I see some 20 mm fire coming down. So yeah, some strafing rounds. Those are the cluster bombs, and those are just going to cluster, truly cluster the area. and drop those, more cluster bombs, some regular bombs, and a whole bunch of hits overall. We'll take a look at the in-depth message log right after all of the strikes come through. But it looks like we are truly doing some damage here. So that industrial area is almost gone. Doesn't look like we hit all of the runway access points, unfortunately, but the runway itself is heavily damaged, or no, medium damage, heavily on fire, so hopefully those two things will cancel each other out, or, you know, at least cause some long-term damage there. And, oh, yeah, there we go, one runway access point has been destroyed, so at least one portion of that runway shouldn't be able to do anything for us or for them in the near future, so that's good. I've got to get everybody to return to base, and that should be more or less the end of this mission here. Right, so let's take a look at the start of that battle and the end of that. Right. So starting off, our plane gives us a intel update on all of those things. I think, yeah, we receive a few vampire missiles at the start of the battle. Luckily, none of those things hit, which is quite nice. Looks like something was trying to defend from all of the strikes, because you can intercept projectiles inside the game, mind you. So something was trying to do that right here, didn't happen, and, well, luckily for us, the strikes got in, so, you know, one target down, three targets down, four targets down, five targets down, and that practically goes, very, very large portion of the stuff that they have there. If my log stops updating, I'll tell you a bit more about it, about what had happened here, but, every time it updates, jumps up to the top here, it looks like what had happened was that a whole bunch of, one of our planes didn't drop its payload, so it made a second run, and, luckily it took out that tarmac space. Going back to where we were, so yeah, we had quite a few nice hits there on the SAM battalions. They tried to react by taking out the missiles, but they missed. Our planes, for whatever reason, decided to strafe the SAMs, and they actually got one nice strafe down, so they managed to take that down. Afterwards, you know, bombs dropped, a whole bunch of bomb drop calculations. All of the GBUs, I think, hit, though some of them didn't necessarily penetrate fully. Some of the dumb bombs, I want to say, missed, but yeah, some of them missed here, but the ones that did hit did quite a lot of damage, so that's nice. And at the very last portion here, it looks like things are just burning up down there. The fire will hopefully do some more damage. For now, what we can do is that we can just speed this up and we can get the entirety of this fleet of ships back to base. It's rather unfortunate that the ECM wasn't able to join us, but that is pretty much just that. Well, hope you guys enjoyed this look into this game here. I'm gonna let it fast forward to the end of the scenario. Hopefully the fires will take out one more building, but if not, I'm fine with that. And there we go, that is the end of the mission. And well, we can now be evaluated based on our performance. So taking a look at that, that is a minor victory. We managed to take out quite a lot of their buildings, but we weren't able to sink their field, if you will, right off the bat, because it looks like we only got two of the runway access points, so the other half of the runway was functioning, and of course we didn't get the actual runway itself, so that's that. But we got the radar tower, we got tarmac space, got a whole bunch of their MiGs, whole bunch of their vehicles, and I would imagine a large amount of those buildings sitting down there as well, so seven buildings. Overall, it's a very fascinating game. Currently, there's right around, like, I think 182 scenarios out for it, and overall, it has been definitely quite a fun game to play. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this Let's Try, and hope you guys pick up this game if you found it just as enjoyable as I did right here. Bye-bye for now.